ready to get started?
Ba 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 brain.
Ba 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 ba.
Is the music too loud? I heard a mixture. Okay. Whoever said yes, find them, smack them.
Thank you.
All right, is the music too loud? Okay. Yeah, we ain't got 32 more songs. It's 31. I'm in. We want to thank all y'all for coming. We're excited to see everybody. As you can see, we like to have fun. There's a lot more I could say, but I won't at this point in time. But we really do appreciate it. And our goal tonight is for you to have good, clean family fun. That's all this is about. And so we appreciate you coming, and we hope you enjoy it. If you don't, then you can talk to Bo back here. He's the complaint guy. Just kidding. He's the young one, so I figure he could fight a little longer than the rest of us could. Anyway, no, we want everybody to enjoy yourself. You see something up there, if it don't have a cord on it, you can have it. But just make yourself at home and enjoy yourself, okay? All right.
Here's one from 1961 by the Drifters.
Tired feet were fire through. Under four walls, down by
Back in 1959, Mr. Richie Valens ranked number 98 in the top 100 with this song right here. We're going to feature Mr. Mickey Jennings right here. All right, settle down, Jeff.
Getting down with his bad self,
man. I knew you shouldn't have had that milkshake.
Okay, we're going to slow it down. This is only one of two slow songs, so grab your honey. We need to fill this we have this gap up here for you people to dance. And the more you get involved, the better it makes us feel. We've been practicing for like 2 years for tonight.
Hey, JR, ready to go?
So we need some lovebirds up here. Don't be shy.
I love how your eyes close whenever you kiss me. I love how you think of me whenever you miss me. And I love the way you always treat me.
right, back in 1963, the Ronettes had the number one single on this song right here. We're going to feature all of these ladies right here. How many of you out there remember the stroll? You're telling on yourself now. Be careful. Be careful.
Get up here.
We need strollers.
We're going to stroll a little bit. Yeah, we need strollers.
Not with wheels on it either.
Any kind of stroller you got. there's my love strolling in the door. There's my love strolling in the door. Baby, let's go strolling by the candy store.
All right, we're going to take you way, way back now. Feature Mickey Jennings again on this one. It's way back in the dinosaur days.
Y'all listen to the words of this song.
Funny papers we all know. He lives way back a long time ago. He don't eat nothing but a bearcat stew. Well, this cat's name is a alley-oo. He got a chauffeur that's a genuine dinosaur. And he can knuckle your head before you count too far. He got a big ugly club and a head full of hair. Like great big lions and grizzly bears. Toughest man there is alive. Wears clothes from a wildcat's hide. He's the king of the jungle gyre.
Look at that caveman go.
He rides through the jungle tearing limbs off a tree. Knocking great big monsters dead on their knees. The cats don't bug him cause they know better. Cause he's a mean motor scooter and a bad go-getter. He's the toughest man there is alive. Wears clothes from a wildcat's hide. He's the king of the jungle. That caveman go. He sure is hip, ain't he? Like, what's happening? He's too much. Right, daddy, right. Hi-yo, dinosaur.
Thank you.
I don't know about y'all, but I'm about alley-ooped out. There's a lot of alley-oops in there. Beg your pardon? Tambourine man.
He tied up making milkshakes. Yeah.
We need to bring Jim up here. I mean, Jim, you just need to sit right here.
Oh, no, I don't make it.
He's bashful. He's kind of shy, too. Here's one by Here's one by Charlie Brown and the Coasters. I had to get my DJ voice going there.
Daisy.
chicken pox will make you jump and twitch. A common cold will fool you, a whooping cough will cool you, but poison ivy, Lord, it make you itch. You're gonna need an ocean, a calamine lotion. You'll be hitting like a hound the minute you start to mess around. Poison ivy.
All right. Are we having fun yet? All right. Once again, we're going to feature Mr. Mickey Jennings over here. We're going to take you back to one by Mr. Carl Perkins of the back from Sun Records days on this one, I think.
Oh, my friends are popping the blues and it must be going round. Oh, my friends are popping the blues and it must be going round. Well, I love you, baby, but I must be rhythm bound. Well, Thank you.
All right. We're gonna do this next song, and right after this song, we're gonna have about a 10-minute break. So if y'all need to wake up and go back to sleep, milkshake, got the soda jerk back there. But anyway, right after this song, we'll take about a 10-15-minute break, and then we'll be right back up and finish this thing up, okay? All right, we're going to take a break. While we're breaking, there's somebody I asked to come up and give y'all some information. I think it would be very good. It's good information for all of us, really. Where's he at? JR? Yeah, here he comes. Is everybody having a good time? Good. You're going to fix that. I was asked to. Asked to answer the phone. No, I was asked to do just a few minute testimony by Brother Eddie, and I don't know if I can do it in a few minutes, so we'll do what we can. But I'll tell you, I'm like Paul in Romans 1:16. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. I've come a long way in a roundabout way getting back here tonight, and I don't know how all of you wound up here, but I imagine there's some similar stories. But I can remember one particular story, how I got back here. Well, first of all, I know it was by God's providence. I was raised here and learned what was right and wrong in this community, just as many of you have. But just as many have gone down that broad path, I did for many years. But thank God we're back here today. But how I got back here, I was out west, and I was in trouble. And God seemed fit to put people in my life. And I was in the service industry, car service industry, and I had this one particular lady that was a very good customer, very good customer. She lived in Cherry Hills. I keep pointing to Carla. Carla's very familiar with Denver and that area. Her name was Catherine, brightest red hair you ever seen. But she was a very nice lady. And me being in the service industry, I moved around a little bit. Started out in the south end of Denver, and I wound up in Boulder. But she followed me everywhere I went. And she was a very, very nice lady, very good friend. She always was very nice to me, and I tried my best to take care of her. I'd take her to the mall when her car was in the shop. But I'd do my best to take care of her just like I would one of my sisters, my mother, grandmother, or whatever. We were taught that here. You go to other places, they're not taught that. We're very blessed with what we have right here. And every time that she would leave, she would have a gift for me. It would be a golf shirt. She knew I loved golf, still do. And before the day was out, every time her husband, I never met him personally, but he became a friend over the phone. He was a very important man. He was an international lawyer. And every time she would come and visit, he would, either that day or the very next day, he would call me. He would take time out to call me and tell me how much he appreciated me taking care of her. That was the love of his life. And he was an older gentleman, and he was always out of the country, but he would time it you know, the time zones and so forth. And his name was Harry. And I want to say it was Harry Reid, but that name's not very popular around here, but I'm not sure about that. Her name was Catherine and his name was Harry, but I'll never forget him. Long story short, I left that industry, and there was some bad things that went down. And the last time Catherine was in, she knew something was wrong, and so she called me personally, and I let her know. And things were so bad at where I had left, and she said, "You need to sue these people." Nah, she said, "No, you need to sue these people. You don't come up with me, baby. You can come up here with me." So I thought about it. things were bad. I said, "I don't know about that." She says, "Well, let me talk to Harry, and we'll see what he says, and I'll have him give you a call." And I'll never forget where I was at. I was on the golf course, Riverdale Dunes. It's a Pete Dye course. Now, I love golf. I've had 3 hole-in-ones. But that day, those were good days, having 3 hole-in-ones. But that day was the best day I ever had on the golf course. I was on hole number 17. And if you're familiar with the Pete Dye course, it's always Island Green, par 3, whatever. I hit a ball in the water and my phone rang. And it was Harry. Harry was very important to me, very wise man. So I pulled my card over just to listen to what he had to say. I done made my mind up. I wasn't suing nobody. I wasn't doing anything like that. And I had my mind made up what I was going to do. But he told me, he said, "JR, I will back you in any way." He says, "You're a very good person." He says, "I love you if you were my only child." And they didn't have any children. All they had was 3 show miniature collies. Very nice people. I said, "Well, I don't know about that, Harry." He says, "Well, good. I want you to listen to me for just a minute." He said, "You're a good guy." He says, "You know, if you went to a psychiatrist, this is what they would do when you're down." He said, "I can tell by the tone of your voice that you're down and out." He says, "And a psychiatrist, what they do when you're in trouble, they pull you out first. Pull you out of the situation. And then they slap you around a little bit. Get you back. You know, and then they build you up so that you can stand on your own 2 feet and go." He says, "And that's what I want you to do." He says, "JR, I want you to go home." He says, "I've never met you personally, and I probably never will." He says, "But you need to go home." He says, "There's something you need to pass along to people. There's something you've got that you need to pass along. Are you passing it along here?" I said, "No." He says, "You need to make arrangements, and if you need my help, I'll help you in any way I can, but you need to go home. Because you've got so much that you need to find somebody to pass that along to." You know, I sat there and squalled. Never finished that round of golf. But that was the best day I've ever had on a golf course. And in a roundabout way, I came home. I came home. And the scripture, Mark 5, chapter 5, verse 19, says, "Go home. Go home to thy friends and tell them how great things the Lord hath done for thee and hath had compassion on you." And I've been back here 20 years now. I'm a Sunday school teacher for
14, 15 years now. And this is one of my sweethearts right here that I can pass things along to. Her name's Jenna. Say hi, Jenna. And I have grandbabies, step grandbabies, but they're my grandbabies around here somewhere that I can pass it along to. I don't know about you, but you're not living it if you're not passing something along. You're not living if you're not passing something along. And I'll leave you with this. There's a second part of Romans 1:16. He says, "For I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ." But he goes on to say, "For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth." And that's what I want to leave you with. It's the power of God unto salvation, and it's for everyone. All we got to do is believe. Thank you.
All right, here's one that me and Brother Jeff's worked on for like 3 years. We was going to scratch it. We was going to like mark it off, but we're going to give it a shot because we worked so hard on it. So We can do it. We can do it. I taught him everything he knows. I'm going to take you back to the 60s with one here by the Beatles. Feature Bo doing that right here for you.
We're working on out.
Yeah. I'd like to say hello. He's going to get me for this, but I'd like to say hello to a good friend of mine. Mr. Todd Anderson from the group Heartland is here tonight. Almost got that ending.
Good job.
I guarantee you if we show up for practice Tuesday night, we'll get it.
Yeah, we'll be waiting on y'all. Yeah, we'll be out that week.
6 o'clock.
What you need. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Brother Eddie wrote that. A lot of people don't know that. Oh.
I didn't know that.
That's one of those professional lies that professional entertainers like us sometimes use, but... We ain't got to rehearse that one, Tuesday. You did good. So are we still doing good out there? Did everybody get plenty to eat? Good. Is there any left? Somebody get me a hot dog. Save it. And a cookie. Here's the only other slow song, so hit the dance floor. We did this last year. We always mess up the intro, so we're gonna do it again.
Smiling face. Thank you.
Is Miss Emily doing it for you? Here's one by Mr. Buddy Holly. We're going to take you back. Well, every one of these is taken back, ain't it? I don't guess we're going forward on any of them. Here's Brother Eddie to do one. He does a good job on this.
No pressure.
Thank you.
a new romance. No more to sorrow, but that's the chance you gotta take if you're lonely. Thank you. Okay, that concludes. Hold on. We're going to do one more song. Y'all keep this up, we're going to go home early. As we said on the outset, our goal tonight was to give people something to do. Good, clean fun. We hope you've had clean fun. We hope you've had good time. We hope you enjoyed all that has been made available to you. We also wanted someone to talk about Jesus, and we was able to do that tonight. We're grateful and thankful to live in a country where we can still gather in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Things are bad, folks, but listen, we don't have any fear about meeting here and opening the Word of God and reading it and believing in it and accepting it. As you heard from JR's testimony about the divine providence of God, we all are experiencing God's grace this very night. Grace means unmerited favor, unearned favor,
We didn't deserve to have all this, but God allowed us to have it, and we're thankful. We're going to end with a song that a lot of you know, and it's How Great Thou Art. There was a lady who was a Christian, and she was out of God's will, and she was living her life like many of us have done in the past, and you may be doing it tonight. But she was hiking in, of all places, up in Colorado in the mountains, and she got caught in an electrical storm. And so she had to find a place to get in, shelter herself from the electrical storm and the winds and the rain that blew. And she found one. And there she penned these words, How Great Thou Art. If you know the song, you sing with us, okay? He is a great God.
Yeah.
None of us would be here without him. None of us.
That's right.
If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, our prayer here at this church, and I may know of many out here as well, hope and pray that you come to know Jesus. It's the greatest decision you'll ever make. Okay? Go to church somewhere. You're welcome here, but if you have a membership, go there. You preacher, appreciate it. And if you're a member there, God appreciates it too. Amen?
Yeah, amen.
All right, thank you. Lily Kate Benson on the end down here. Her first time. She is now an international star. Miss Emily Dubin and Stevens. She was a Dubin. So that mean old Stevens guy come along. And Sybil. And this is Judy Donovan. Corey Mullins back here on the guitar. Miss Janice White on the keyboard. Bo Priest playing the guitar. Rodney Powell on the drums. Landon Holman on the bass. Brother Jeff Bennett, my brother, my pastor, my best friend, pastor at Cornerstone over on Ryland Pike. So if you live in that area, go by there and give him some money. He'd appreciate it. Brother Mickey Jennings playing the lead, singing. Brother Charlie White on the end. Stephanie Payne. She loves how y'all love her. And this is Miss Mandy Anthony. I'll get it right. And I don't know who I am, but listen, thank y'all very much. God bless y'all very much. You're Bo.
We said Bo. We said Bo.
Where y'all been?
Ladies and gentlemen, Brother Eddie Clardy, yeah. On lead vocals.
Who ain't up here? Amy Vinson. Mallory Mills. They got babies in their lap. They help with the backup. There's been a lot of people who worked very hard to get this done. As you can see, the decorations, all the things, the ladies have worked hard, the food, these soda jerks. Do y'all know that's what they're called? We're going to get them tags next year. It's got big jerk. Soda jerk. But no, they've worked hard. Everybody's worked real hard. The band's worked for quite a few months now. And we enjoy it. We have a good time. But our number one goal is to uplift Jesus Christ. And we lift him up. And if we can't do this and still lift up Jesus, then we're going to lift up Jesus. Our world needs Jesus. Our world needs Jesus. And you know what? God saved me and he saved you and he left us here to serve him. And how we serve him is we get in his word, we apply his word to our life, and our life is to be lived according to his word, and that lifts him up. That's what scripture tells us. He's fixing to do a nosedive right here. All right, go to church somewhere. Thank you very much. Brother JR, thank you. God bless you.